A Fox 45 News investigation finds millions of your tax dollars are going to educate students who aren't in school.
As Project Baltimore's Chris Papps explains, Maryland's comptroller has seen our reporting and now says the way public schools are funded needs to change.
But I lived through the Thornton area years ago.
Peter Franchot, first as a delegate and now as state comptroller, has been involved in school funding debates since the 1980s.
They promised us this is all paid for, and by the way, it's billions of dollars, and it's going to absolutely transform the system. It didn't.
So earlier this year, when lawmakers passed the largest education spending increase in our state's history, known as the Kirwan Plan, Franchot had some criticisms.
Having a press conference and saying we're spending billions of dollars on education is not the same thing as improving the product.
The Kirwan Plan pumps billions more dollars into public education every year. But critics like Franchot say additional money must come with additional accountability. And a Project Baltimore investigation found there is cause for concern.
From August up until December.
So from August to December of 2019, you were incarcerated?
Yes.
Project Baltimore, in April, spoke to this man whose name appears on a list of students at Augusta Fells Savage High School in West Baltimore. He told us he may have been enrolled at the school, but he wasn't there because he was in jail.
Didn't enroll in the class or anything. I've been gone since 2017, buddy.
Ghost students, as they're known by educators, are only enrolled on paper. Keeping more students on the roster, even if they don't show up, can boost the amount of money a school receives. After Project Baltimore identified 21 potential ghost students at Augusta Fells, an internal investigation by city schools found the problem was much larger. Up to 100 students with questionable enrollment status were found at just this one school.
It's unacceptable for taxpayers' money to go for students that are knowingly not in the school system.
Project Baltimore analyzed state data and found at Augusta Fells, 40 students in 2019 were labeled W50, which means whereabouts unknown. Throughout the entire state in 2019, it was 6,126 students. Maryland schools in 2019 received on average $15,148 of funding per student. That adds up to nearly $93 million to educate students that, according to state data, could not be found.
The fact that we're funding students whose whereabouts are unknown, and not a small number, thousands, and it adds up to tens of millions of dollars, that's something that needs to be looked at.
Franchot, who is now running for governor, says to fix the problem, we must change the way schools are funded. Right now, Maryland schools receive 100% of their funding based on the number of students enrolled by September 30th.
So you think it does make more sense to fund schools based off attendance than this one day a year enrollment on September 30th?
Yes, I do agree with that. It's a very simple solution. Instead of taking one tally at September 30th to see who's in school and who's out of school, they need to do it monthly.
Franchot says tying funding to attendance would also give schools an incentive to engage kids and keep them in the classrooms, because a student cannot learn if they're not there.
What we're doing now is just tragic, I think, because we're committing the state in a direction where we know the kids that are graduating don't have the skill, the knowledge, or the self-confidence to independently take advantage of the free enterprise system.
I'm Chris Pabst, and this is Project Baltimore.
Fox 45 News is committed to a long-term investigation into public education. Project Baltimore, our award-winning investigative team, has been focused on this topic for nearly 5 years and understands parents and taxpayers want transparency from their public schools.
We're taking the pulse of Baltimore. Do you think school funding should be based on attendance? Go to foxbaltimore.com/vote and click on the Pulse tab to weigh in.